So if we drop this in the area, it should place them down. Hopefully. Yeah! What's up, people? I'm Zog, and welcome to my world. We're here, we're doing things, back on FTB Unstable, Minecraft 110. And you guys, so far, you're liking this. Now, the last video just went live at the time of recording, so I haven't gotten too many suggestions for this yet, but I have gotten a couple. Somebody said to do spikes. Well, actually, that's the only one I got as far as this area here is concerned anyway. But, yeah, I don't know. There's a... They're coming in, but I'm going to wait for them to come in before I actually act on anything, just to see what other people think. Now, I do have an idea for blending. But as you see, I'll get back to blending here in a minute. I'll tell you exactly what I mean. But I did get the other four, or the other three of these staircases built, and they go down pretty far. They go all the way down until they hit the ground and you know, blend into the ground that way. I'll probably create paths and stuff to various locations. I'm not sure exactly where they're going to lead or what they're going to be just yet. For now, we're going to leave them alone and just let them kind of blend into the ground. But as what I mean by blending before is actually because of the dark stuff. It kind of looks a little separated right now, like the certain parts of the pyramid just don't fit together. And I think that's because the darkness needs to be spread out a little more. So I think what I'm going to do, I guess we'll go here too, is I'm going to start doing something like this. And I'm going to go all the way across so it does blend like this. I think I need one more actually. I think there's, oh, no, no, I think that's it actually. So we go around here. I don't really need that one to be covered, to be honest. There's no reason to have that one covered. Also, it's a little weird. My CAD is selected right now. You see I'm placing blocks. It should be the actual block, but if I go here and then scroll over after using, I guess, yeah, see, now it's still the gun. It's still the CAD device that's here, even though I'm placing blocks. It's a little glitch, and what I mean is the thing I'm holding, basically, the thing in my hand is still showing the CAD when it should be the block. It's just kind of weird. Anyway, so... see, that tricks me. It tricks me sometimes. But I think by doing this, it'll blend in the staircase with the side part, so it doesn't look like there's so much difference between all of these, and it'll kind of blend everything in together, I think. This is my hope, that everything will look like it belongs there, and it won't be so incredibly different the whole time. The other thing I want to do is actually get some... Let's see... I don't know. I wanted some bits. I wanted to have some bits in my bag here that are the spruce wood so I could play with them. Oh, that's what I was going to do. Okay, I was going to put a cover on these guys. I was going to have the spruce wood actually cover over this because these guys right here are not going to remain spruce wood. Eventually, they're going to be removed. There it goes tricking me again. Eventually, they're going to be removed in favor of the runes for the Tier 6 blood altar. So they're not always going to be spruce wood. That's why the second layer of spruce wood is down there at the bottom, because these are going to be runes at some point. Oh, look, it's dark. Oh, I got to go sleep. Oh, yay. Yippee. I still haven't tested the whole changing this to a Minecraft bed. I do apologize for that, because, yeah, right now I'm using commands, and it's not the best thing to do. But we'll have to check. I will check that out at some point. But you see, I'm going to the bed. It's not really cheating. Somebody even mentioned that. It was like, dude, you're going to the bed every time. You're not doing anything wrong. Just move on. But anyway, so there's that. I'm going to finish laying these out on the front corners of these places right here just to see how well it works. And then I want to try one more concept to see... there we go. To see how good it looks. I want to basically... Duplicate. There we go. I want to do this guy on the front of them to kind of give a little bit more. Not on the top one here, but this guy right here. So if we do the first few like so, and then we basically do this. Where's my bag at? Here we go. I need to see how full it is. Yeah. So basically, if we do that, should we leave it as full blocks or should we do and chop them all down like this? Because this bottom one right here is also going to be... That's not what I wanted. You need to be put back. Okay, good. Now, this bottom one here, if you remember, the staircase is actually chopping into the pyramid a little bit. So we have that kind of an issue that it's not going to be exactly the same along all of the levels. So for example, let me finish this off real quick and I'll show you what I mean. If we do this to the first few here again, this guy is actually even. It's dead even with the staircase. This one is back one block and this one's back two blocks. One full block, and this one's actually back half a block, I guess, is what it really is. But you get the gist that it's kind of receding back a little bit. It's going further and further back, which isn't bad. I don't think it looks terrible on that side. It might not look as good if we keep the full blocks here, though. So I don't know. I think it'll look better if we do indeed slope the corners. I think that'll end up looking better if we slope them all. So let me go ahead and do that. Let me finish off all the corners on all the sides, which is going to take a little bit because I don't know if I have that much spruce wood actually. But let me do that and yeah, we'll check it out. Okay, so now that I have all of these guys done, if we take a look around, it definitely does help. Now comes the time to kind of populate the sides. Now I'm going to play with something just for a little while, just to see if it works. There's going to be more to do with it, but I wanted to play with a concept. Something that I was thinking about in my head. If I don't play with it now, I'm never going to remember to do it later. So we're going to take care of it right this second and see if we can get it. Now you see I have all four of my pure daisies now in floating island form. Now, they will work. If I put any logs or stone around here, they will be converted into living wood or living rock. And, you know, there won't be a problem with that. But the problem is that I want to automate this. And if you don't know, we don't have any block placers. Now, if you know that if I do have a block placer, do let me know. But I wanted to play with something else that I know we have. Hi, pumpkin. Halloween style stuff, I guess. That's cool. Anyway, so it's in October. I'm recording this in October, so I guess Halloween things come out and play. But, so I wanted to play with something. If we take a look at this guy right here, the Ronancarpus? Ronancarpus? Something like that. That's handy. That's what it says. It's a function of flower. What it does is basically it will pick up any nearby blocks in dropped item form and place them in the world nearby. It, however, only places the blocks thrown at it on top of a specific block. To specify this block, place it right below the soil the flower is resting on. Now, there's something I want to play with before I may end up wasting one of these. Okay, it says in order to specify what block you want things to be placed on top of, to put that below the soil. But if I make it into a floating island form like this, does the island itself count as the soil? And therefore, can I use the alabaster right below? So if I put a floating island right here, will it place blocks on top of other alabaster blocks? I don't know. I do not know the answer to this question. I need to figure it out. But first, I need to make the flower. To make the flower, I need a redstone root, two orange, a yellow, and a rune of earth, which I have one of, so we're going to test it with one, but we're going to need more, so I need stone, block of coal, mushrooms. Actually, I may not have one of these. I'm not sure. Mana powder, mana steel. You get it. I just need to make a few supplies here to see if we can actually get this guy going. Now, I do have actually two of them. I have one that is not on a floating island just yet. We're going to convert that over if this works. What I want to do is this guy doesn't even require any mana. It really doesn't. It even says that in the book. If we open this guy and go back, it says a block item sugarcane will also work, but much like any other blocks, will only be placed in a location where they normally would be able to be placed. Lastly, giving mana to the flower is optional, but it increases its range. So if I don't need the increased range, all I have to do is just... if I don't need the increased range, I don't need to... give it to mana, so it's free, which is really good. Set time day. Okay. What? I did that wrong. Time set. There we go. So, now that that is settled, what I want to do is basically I want to put one here. Hopefully it works. And we're going to see. Because right now it has soil as the island. I I'm hoping that counts as the soil, so the block beneath it is alabaster. So any blocks we drop in the area should be placed on other alabaster blocks. And if we need to, well, what I'll end up doing is changing this block out for something completely different, maybe spruce or something. And that way it won't place in like random places like, well, actually anywhere it places except for here and here will be fine, really, because then they'll all still work. But other than that, yeah. So what I'm looking for, I don't know. I'm gonna be doing some other stuff in order to automate the breaking of the blocks. There is something you can do with mana spreaders, I believe, that can break blocks as well, which is really, really handy and really cool. And then we could use a hopper hawk to pick them up. So Batania is like a fully featured thing, and I've never really gone this far with it, but I want to play with it. But the first thing to do is that I need to get some stone. Let's just try it with stone first. Give me some stone here and see if this actually works. So if I drop this in the area, it should place them down. Hopefully. Yeah! Totally, look at that thing go. And that's a pretty big range too. Well, that was a little quick cut there, had a little bit of an interruption. But yeah, it's a big range. I'm not sure where I chopped it off at. But yeah, this is where it placed those blocks. So what I wanna do now, I shouldn't have used stone right away. I guess it'll still convert them. I could have just waited. It'll convert that one and that one, not this one. It would have converted the other one too, I think. But oh well, now I have a couple cobblestone. That's fine, it's whatever, I don't really care. Now what I wanna do is, that's really, really good. All right, so what block? I need some random, oh. Yeah, look, holy crap, it placed it all the way up here. That is an incredible range. That is a nutso range. Actually, I tell you what I can do. For example, and this way I'll know exactly what, I'll know exactly which one does what. So if I do, not lock, no, nothing about lock. If I put living rock down here, I need this guy and I need you. Actually, no, I don't want this other one here. Or the ones underneath these guys. So give me back these. I don't want... I'm trying to think, okay? If I... I'm trying to think. Shut up with all your loudness. If I'm going to have mana bursts to break the blocks, then they're going to go a straight line all the way down, right? So on both sides. So I don't want the middle pieces. I don't want any of these to be living rock. None of them need to be living rock. This guy does right there. And then the entire line over here does. You, there we go. And then I go all the way down the line here, except for a couple places in the middle. And then you on this side. So if we break all of these blocks and then replace them, oh, well, not all of them are going to be living rock. Actually, the only living rock we're gonna have is you. That's not gonna be you, and you, and then on the other side over here is also going to be living rock like so. And then that way, and then the rest is gonna be alabaster, which is going to cover the middles like so. And then over here, you and you are also gonna be that, and then I want living wood. Do I have any living wood? I don't think I do, actually. No, I don't have any living wood. How much do I need? 6, 12, so I need 13 pieces of this. Wonderful, so now if I go in here and go to floating island, like, oh, I already had it down there. Ha 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 ha, you. Now we can clear you. And I can bring you over here. If we take a look, basically what we have here is this design. It's actually a really, really cool thing. I like the way that turned out. It's pretty cool, because they're kind of X's. There's kind of X's in there. So if we go ahead and place this guy down here, what we should be able to do is throw down, what are you looking at? 12 wood per, right? I think it's 12. So that should place all 12 of those blocks here on top of only living wood, which is beautiful. I love it. Look at that. That's great. That's perfect. That's exactly what I want. So every 12 is what I'm looking for. That's what I would like to see. Is if we go here, now I need to do 12 here. Bloop. And that should place all 12 of those. Yay! Look at it go! That's beautiful. That is absolutely wonderful. I love that. That turned out really good. And now I know exactly this side is going to give me living wood, and this side is going to give me living rock. Now comes the breaking of them. I need to break these flowers, and the little break that I have in here is also perfect because I can put hopper hawks in here. I can put a hopper hawk in here and over here. And that way, when I shoot the mono... Well, I guess I can't put the hopper... Well, I might be able to do it if it's a floating island. The monoburst might go right through it. It might stop. I don't know how monoburst work. We're going to have to check that out, actually. So, if I can figure out how to do the breaking a block with a monoburst, then I can have a hopper hawk just collect all those blocks. And then we have a fully... Well, actually, I have to drop the items, too. So, I can just use a regular... There's probably a flower that breaks, that drops them too, and I can put that right on this side, which is kind of perfect if it works out that way. So, oh, well, I can do that, but it would have to go into an inventory. So I would have to export certain items into the chest, have a timer on that flower or on the chest or something, so it only spits out 12 at a time. That would be a little complicated. I'm gonna have to work that one out later. But what I wanna do is see if I can't look up in this guy, see if I can figure out the mana manipulation of the mana spreader, pulse mana spreader. Mana spreader with a piece of redstone, it is possible to create a pulse mana spreader, which, as the name implies, fires when given a redstone pulse, regardless of having a block in the end to put the mana or not. To keep note that this doesn't let the spreader shoot a burst until the last one dissipates or is absorbed. Okay. So that's how we make the pulse. But what about mana detector, mana distributor, flux field, mirror, mana void, mana. Okay, so it's probably a lens, I'm thinking. The one can apply mana lenses. Very basic mono lens does absolutely nothing. All 16 colors of the spectrum are combined with mono pearl to create a rainbow lens. These will change the color of the burst. That's cool. We can change the color. That's fine. Let me see if I can look through this so we're not looking through the entirety of the whole book together. There's a lot of stuff that you can do with the mono lenses. Now you can just a little bit of them is efficiency, like you can double increase the distance mana can travel before it starts to be lost. You can increase the how much you can send at one time. You can decrease those things. You can have it affected by gravity. You can have it blow up things. You can have it set things on fire. I don't know, it's really cool. But the one I'm talking about, bounce off of walls. The one I'm talking about is the boar lens. The boar lens charges the mana burst with the ability to break any blocks it comes into contact with, draining its own mana to do so. So my question is, if I do this, can I... Ooh, interesting. Is there going to be enough mana in the burst to go across the 12 blocks it needs to get to the other end? Or is the distance too much and then I'll start to lose mana? I don't know the answers to these questions. So what I might have to do is put a mana pool right in the middle here and have one shoot this way and one shoot that way. And then have another one here that goes back into it. But see, then that won't work because I need it. I need something to catch it. I need to have it in a circle. Because my original idea was to have a monopole right here on either end. On both ends, on this side, have a monopole here and one over there. And then from this side, it'll shoot the monoburst all the way across, breaking all of these blocks. And then it'll hit a monopole that I will... No, see, then the monopole has to be here. I need it to, like, I can shoot it into another mana spreader that will then shoot it into the monopole. So it'll go all the way down and then back into the mana pool. This one will use that same mana and shoot it all the way down in the same deal. Now, I do have to replenish it because if we take a look back into here, into the boar lens, it does drain its own mana. So I will have to have some kind of mana coming in over here in order for this to continue to work forever. But right now, I can just kind of charge it up with a little bit of this stuff. And we can leave that alone and that'll be fine because I do passively gain mana from this thing, which is really, really cool. I want to get the Terra Steel version of the Band of Aura because it'll work better. And I'll just be able to get mana that way, which is really, really cool. Now, this guy is actually using mana. These guys use mana all the time, no matter what, which is really kind of not good. I don't like it at all, but it is what it is. We're going to have to deal with that. But I think what I can do in order to provide mana here is that I can actually have the food processors up here. Our Gormorillus flowers can be up here giving mana to whatever system we want to have. And we can hide certain things down in the mountain as well. Because mountain and inside the pyramid as well. Because we do have a little bit of room to play in here. And if I ever decide to go on the inside of this, which I do actually have plans to do so, I don't know exactly how yet, but I do have plans to do so in the future, I can hide it later or move things around so I can hide it. But we'll deal with that later. For right now, I need to see if I can actually have a mana burst go all the way through one block of this. So I need a mana pool with a little bit of mana, which I can give it from here. I need a mana spreader aimed down that way to go into another mana pool. So I need two mana spreaders, two mana pools, the boar lens, and some mana. I think that's all I need. So I'm going to go make that stuff. The mana spreader shouldn't be that difficult. Do I have enough gold for it? I do. Do I have enough living wood for it? I don't, but guess what I have over here? Actually, this is enough for two mana spreaders, exactly, so perfect. And I have the petals I need, I have the gold I need, I have the living rock that I need. So really, I shouldn't have any problems. How do I make the lens itself? Because I didn't actually check that out. It's basically this one. So the piston, not a problem, lapis, not a problem, redstone, not a problem, shift click. Four mana steel and a piece of glass is not a big deal at all either. So I can either even use a glass pane or a piece of glass. So we're good to go there. Let me go ahead and set all this stuff up and we'll check it out here in a second. All right. So now that that's done, what I need to do is this. So now this should have the boar lens. It looks like it does. I'll take a look afterwards. You can kind of see the green there. It's kind of right on the front, so it should be able to bore through blocks. So what I want to do is actually go ahead and empty this guy out into it. Bam, 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 bam. It didn't make it. Oh. That's not good. Ooh. Interesting. Interesting. So how do I deal with that? Oh, that's not good. Okay. How do I specify what blocks it's allowed to place? Can I even do that? Huh. Interesting. And it's not good to use these blocks either because then it'll just keep stacking the blocks on top of each other forever. And then we'll have situations like this right here where we'll just kind of get the leftover blocks. That's not working how I want it to. Not even a little bit is that working how I want it to. Look at you. Stop it now. Crapo. That's not good. Look at this thing though. This looks pretty cool. There's the lens here, which is really kind of neat. I like the way that looks. It's pretty cool. All right, so I need to change out these blocks, and I also need to see if there is a way to specify or at least blacklist what blocks this thing will place. Because it seems to place anything, which is fine. I mean, I guess it's okay. But I don't think the Hopper Hawk will actually pick up. I think the flower here, I think this guy will use it before it has a chance to pick, before the Hopper Hawk can actually pick it up, I think. And I can't place this, I can't delay this because the block it's sitting on would have to be Podsoul or Mycelium for that to work. And I need this to specify what block. I guess I could put Podsol here or Mycelium here if I had those. I don't know. I'm not sure. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and wait for your suggestions. I can't talk, apparently. Wait for your suggestions on these guys, if you have any, on how I can work around some of the issues that I've already talked about. But for now, we're gonna move on. And I have kind of skipped ahead a little bit. If we take a look at the area here, we already have the bound blade, which really is not all that difficult to get. Alright, that's the only reason I got it, is because it really wasn't hard. You already know that I got the living armor. Let's take a look real quick. We did this with the binding reagent, and again, I still don't know how to pronounce that word, and the iron helmet. Well, the bound blade, if we go to bound, the bound items, the bound blade is the same thing except with a diamond sword. So I just went ahead and got this, and then I went over to my little area over there with the cursed earth that I have already set up. You've already seen me over there a bunch, and I killed a bunch of things until I got a couple of weak demon shards. These guys right here, weak blood shards. These guys, I got two of them. Just by killing enemies with an activated bound blade, you get a couple, just kill stuff, you get it. So I have those, and then I went ahead and I made some bloodstone bricks. So the bloodstone bricks are right here. And in order to get to tier 4, we need those. But we also need those for something else that I want to play with. That something else is for the ethereal blocks. I wanted to check these guys out, actually. So what I need is I need the tier 3 shard. I need the tier 3 shard. Tier 3 blood orb in here. I can't do it with the tier 2 one that I currently have. So then, if we take a look at the blood orb for tier 3, what do we need? A block of gold and 25,000 LP, which is kind of crazy. That's a bunch. There's a bunch in there with that. So I'm going to try my little setup here with the Fallen Kanati. Yes, I know I'm pronouncing that wrong. I'm doing it on purpose, just in case for those who didn't see the last episode, or not. The last episode we did Blood Batanian. When we did the last time we did the Fallen Kanati stuff. I was doing it on purpose. Anyway, so here, if we go to, where's my, here you are. You. Okay. Give all of that to here. Dump it all into there. Are you done? Are you done? Are you done? You're done. Perfect. So now it's going to start gaining mana. We're going to leave that alone. We're going to place this guy down here in a second. I need to make sure I get my food back for that. So what I want to do is go ahead. I'm going to prick myself a bunch and throw in this guy. Put down the flower over on this side probably, which is going to give me regeneration, and it's going to start using the mana right away. I want to see how much do we have in here. It's not a huge amount. It's not a whole lot. Hopefully it should last a while though. It should last long enough, I think. But 25,000, it's going to take a while. It's going to take a pretty long time to actually get there. So let's go ahead and bring this back down. So what I need to do is stab myself a bunch. And we almost fill it up because we do have the self-sacrifice runes. We do have the speed runes. So things convert faster just by a little bit. And I do get more blood when I pinch myself with this knife thing here. So I'm going to do that and I'm going to eat. Just like so, and then we're going to put down the flower. I'm going to put down this, and then I'm going to put down the flower. See, it's soaking it up pretty quick here, so that's kind of a thing. Oh. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. And then, as long as I remain fully... Oh, wow, it is going pretty quick. Oh, my goodness. Holy crap. Eat! Okay, so it's apparently I'm not doing it fast enough. So I am fully healed, though. I can kind of do this and keep it above board. There! Oh, well, wow, I did it. It worked already. That's really crazy. Okay, good. Wow, I didn't think it would go that fast. I thought it would take a lot longer. Holy crapo. That's really amazing. That's great. I love it. All right, anyway. So now that that's done, I'm going to go ahead and get rid of this guy. We're not yet to tier 4, so I can't get the tier 4 orb, which, by the way, is still only 25,000. And it's a weak blood shard, which we already have both of those, but I'm not tier 4 because I need to get all of the runes. That's the only thing we need for tier 4 in blood magic is the runes, because we also already have the large bloodstone bricks that go on top of these. all four of them. So once we get the runes, we're good. But for right now, we're going to hold off on that. We're going to leave this guy up here because that went really, really well. I didn't think it would go that well. But I do actually, I need a couple of blank slates first. Let me go ahead and get a stone or two, two stone, and this. Let me go back up here. We're going to get a couple of these guys. Wait, let's do this. Prick my finger a bunch. Not a, like a bunch, but a bunch. I'm going to eat, and I'm going to put a stone in. Piece of stone. One piece of stone. We're going to do this. As soon as it converts over the first time, then we take it out. Put the second stone in, and then it will also convert. Boom. Okay. Now, the reason I needed these is because I also need a blank rune for the recipe to play with the ethereal block. For each one of them, I need that. So what I wanted to do, though, I have an idea for this. If we go like this. Okay, that didn't work. Oh, I need the blank rune first. Don't I? I does. All right, give me the this guy. So give me the blank rune. And then you can go here. Actually, we'll do this. And then we'll do this. And then we'll do this. And then this. And I get four of them for the one recipe, which is perfect. So now that we have the ethereal blocks, I wanted to play with these guys because it's they're pretty cool. They're ethereal, so they shouldn't be real, basically. They're like ghost blocks. But they're ethereal opaque mimic blocks. So they're going to look like you can't go through them. They're going to mimic what's around them, and they're not actually going to be there because they're ethereal. So I think I'm saying that right. Hopefully I'm saying that right. So I want to play with these to see if maybe I can use them to go into our pyramid and actually use them as an entrance. And that way I don't have to destroy the aesthetic of up here, and I can put things down and around on all these levels, and it doesn't really matter because when I want to go inside, all I have to do is just like sneak in through blocks that look real but aren't. So how do we... Yeah, see, we can walk right through them. But how do we set the texture of them? No. Okay, so how do I... That's not what I wanted. There's got to be a way to set the texture. Wrench. Is there like a blood magic wrench or something? Blood magic. I don't... There's swords and stuff. Master routing node. That's not what I want either. Efficiency runes. Node router. Also not what I want. Ritual tinkerer. Okay, so what do I have to make to control this guy? Okay, so let's see if this guy helps. This guy is supposed... I don't know what it's supposed to be. Set it to tier 2, 3, 4, 5... Set to tier 3? What? What is happening? Inspectors... Whoa! These symbols seem to be shifting. Current tier 5. 6. 1. What do you do? I don't know what you're supposed to do. What? Tome of... What? It's weird. I thought it was going to be like the blood magic book. I'm trying to figure out how to work the thing. How do I make these blocks? Well, you guys are going to have to tell me. You guys are going to have to tell me because I don't know how to make these blocks work. Now, I need these blocks to work. So that's number one thing to tell me. And number two thing to tell me is just any ideas on the stuff I talked about here. So, yes, that is about all the time I have for this episode. If you did like it, don't forget to hit that like button. If you want to see more of my videos sent directly to you, then don't forget to subscribe. Comment if you share, feel like you want to. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time. Peace out, peeps. I think that looks really cool. It's coming together. I mean, there's a lot of pink in there, but hey, whatever. Call Jenny, really? Really, guys? Why is that something? Oh, use ladder. There's a ladder. Whoa, I teleported. That's cool. Let's climb to the top of the building. Is there anything here? Is there anything below me? I don't know. That's pretty neat, man. I just teleported through the building. And popped onto a ladder. Yeah. Oh no! That killed me? Why would that kill me? That shouldn't kill me.